Hello. In today's video, we shall learn in detail about Markentia, which is a thalloid liver wart. By the end of this video, you will have a clear understanding about external features of Markentia, its anatomy, modes of reproduction, and its life cycle showing alternation of generations. Let us start with the introduction to Markentia. Markentia is a rosid type of thalloid liver wart. It is a genus of non-vascular land plants included in bryophytes. All species are terrestrial and cosmopolitan in distribution. Markentia prefer moist and shady places and grow rapidly during the rainy season. Markentia polymorpha is a well-known species. Let us look into the external features of gametophyte. The plant body is a gametophyte. The thalloid is flat, prostrate, dichotomously branched with a dorsi-ventral symmetry. On the dorsal surface, there is a conspicuous median midrib. An apical notch is seen where the midrib ends. Along the midrib on the dorsal surface are the cup-shaped vegetative or asexual reproductive structures called gemma cups. Sexual reproductive structures are also present on the dorsal surface. The male plant bears special, erect, stalked structures called antheridiophores with a circular disc or receptacle on the top. The female plant bears special branches called archegoniophores with a star-shaped disc or receptacle with radiating arms. On its ventral surface, the thallus bears a number of hair-like structures called rhizoids. Rhizoids are unicellular and branched. They help in anchoring the thallus on the substratum and also help to absorb water and mineral nutrients from the soil. 2 to 4 rows of scales are also present. They are multicellular and one cell thick. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Next, let us study the anatomy of the gametophyte. The thallus of Markentia shows differentiation into 2 layers, an upper photosynthetic layer or zone and a lower storage zone. The upper photosynthetic zone is the dorsal part of the thalloid with a well-defined upper epidermis made up of thin-walled, compactly arranged cells containing chloroplast. Barrel-shaped air pores are present, which are surrounded by several concentric rings of cells. Each pore opens into the air chamber and is responsible for the exchange of gases during photosynthesis. It also contains cup-shaped gemma cups. Storage zone lies below the air chambers. They are made up of several layers of thin-walled parenchymatous cells, which are compactly arranged without any intercellular spaces. The cells lack chloroplast but store proteins, starch, oil, and mucilage. Next, let us understand the various modes of reproduction. Vegetative reproduction may take place by the decay of the old basal portion of the thallus. The new ones that survive develop into a new plant body. Vegetative reproduction in Marchantia is mainly by characteristic asexual reproductive bodies known as gemmae produced in the gemma cups. Each gemma is a small, circular, flattened, multicellular structure which is attached at the base of the gemma cup by a single-celled stalk. Gemma is autotrophic, contains parenchymatous cells, oil cells, and rhizoidal cells. It shows two hollow notches, one each on the lateral margin. In these depressions lies the growing point. Next is dissemination and germination of gemmae. Mucilage hairs secrete mucilage which imbibe water and swells up. This creates a pressure causing the gemmae to get detached from the stalk. Gemmae are dispersed by water currents. After falling on a suitable substratum, each gemma grows out into a dichotomously branched green thallus. Next, let us study the sexual reproduction in Marchantia. Marchantia polymorpha is a dioecious species. The male and female sex organs develop on different thalli. The male plant bears antheridia on stalked structures called antheridiophores, and the female plant bears archegonia on archegoniophores. The antheridia develop in acropetal manner. The oldest are found in the center, while the young ones occupy the periphery. The antheridia are within the flask-shaped antheridial chamber. Each antheridial chamber contains a single antheridium. A mature antheridium has a short stalk and a globular body which has a protecting covering of sterile jacket. It encloses a number of anthrozoid mother cells. Each mother cell develops a spindle-shaped biceliate male gamete called the anthrozoid. The archegonium is a flower-shaped structure with two distinct parts, a venter and a neck. A swollen basal portion called the venter consists of a large cell, the egg cell, and the egg nucleus in it. The second part is a narrow tubular portion, the neck, which consists of few neck canal cells and a wall around it. An outgrowth known as involucre or perichaetium acts as a protective covering around the archegonia. Another outgrowth known as perigynium is formed after fertilization and surrounds the archegonia to give protection. Next step is fertilization. When the antheridium bursts, the ciliated anthrozoids escape through a narrow canal known as ostiole. Many anthrozoids swim and enter the venter of the archegonium, but only one of them fuses with the egg nucleus, resulting in fertilization. The egg cell, after fertilization, form a wall and become an oospore. After fertilization, the archegonophore elongates and the lobes of the disc grow and curve down, bearing the archegonia on its under surface. The archegonia hang with their necks directed downwards. Now, let us study about the sporophyte of Marchantia. The oospore germinates in situ and forms the sporophyte. A mature sporophyte consists of foot, seta, and capsule. Foot is the expanded portion at the base of the sporangium, which acts as an absorbing and anchoring organ. The short-lived sporophyte is dependent on the gametophyte for anchorage and nourishment. Seta is the elongated stalk that connects the foot to the capsule. It is also responsible in pushing the mature capsule out of the calyptra. The capsule consists of a single layered wall and a mass of cells. Some of these cells grow into spindle-shaped structures called elaters, which help in pushing the spores out of the capsule. Other cells of the capsule form spore mother cells. Each spore mother cell undergoes meiosis, resulting in four haploid spores in the form of a tetrad. Calyptra, which is formed from the wall of the venter, surrounds the capsule while the neck disappears. The sporangium of Marchantia develops within three coverings, calyptra, perigynium, and perichetium. When the capsule dehisces, the spores are liberated. The spores germinate and develop into Marchantia thalli. One half of the spore grow into male thalli and the other half into female thalli. Finally, we shall look into the alternation of generation. The life cycle of Marchantia is haplodiplontic. The main free living plant body is the gametophyte, which is haploid, and the sporogonium is the sporophyte, which is diploid. The male and female gametophyte give rise to the antheridium and archegonium respectively. The antheridium forms the anthrozoids and the archegonium forms the ovum or egg. Both anthrozoid and the ovum fuse to form a diploid zygote and then the oospore. It divides by mitotic division to form a multicellular sporophyte consisting of foot, seta, and capsule. Spore mother cells in the capsule undergo reduction division and forms haploid spores, which germinates to form the haploid gametophyte. So today, we have learned in detail about the external features and anatomy of Marchantia, its various modes of reproduction, and its life cycle showing alternation of generations. I have some practice questions for you. Please share your answers in the comment section below. You can pause the video and write down the questions if you like. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notifications of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.